Friends and family, we have come here today to celebrate love. We see it in the faces of David and Gwen, who stand before us. But we experience it in our hearts as well. This love is powerful enough to untie the strong entangled knot of life. It is a love which is spoken of in all religions, which kindles our souls with hope, and which is our true home, our true meeting place. David and Gwen have each experienced the uniqueness of love and companionship, honoring their vows in their previous marriages. Following the passing of their partners, it became clear living alone was not for them. Having much more love to offer, they each, in their separate ways, began searching for that special someone to fill the void. Being realistic, both were aware that this would be an interesting adventure. In what was to be their golden year. Taking the lead from the younger generation, they found the equalizer of a social network on the net. More specifically, eHarmony. The other meeting place, or for the moment of their first meeting, love did blossom. The other meeting place is at this very moment. Today we gather together at the beautiful Beach Club Resort at 12 something on the 12th day of the 12th year of the millennium. However, all of us knowing when, we have to believe, like Gwen, that there must be a great significance attached to the number 12. And there is. In numerology, the number 12 symbolizes strength, conviction, absoluteness, and finality. What better attributes could be attached to a wedding of this magnitude? If any further evidence could be added to the number 12 that binds this union, it should be noted that they met on the 12th of April. With this thought in mind, David and Gwen have invited you, the dearest members of their family, and very best of friends, to sanctify and fulfill your lives with their joy, and above all, the love that is shared by them. They also wish to remind all of us that love will bring the peace that makes our lives and the world a better place. Please take with you today the warmth of the love that David and Gwen wish to share with each of you. Share to mend any rends you have in your own hearts, and thereafter share it with all people and creatures you come upon from this time forward. Who brings this woman, and with whose blessings does she come?
I do, and with love and blessings from friends and family.
David and Gwen have opened their hearts to one another. And today, in just a few minutes, will share their hearts with us as well, inviting us to witness and share in this precious moment. To this day, they bring the fullness of their being as a treasure to share with one another. Their marriage is being entered into reverently with a recognition of a true union which has been discovered. For what greater joy is there of two human souls than to join together to strengthen each other in all their endeavors, to support each other through all sorrow, and to share with each other in all gladness. We hope that the words and spirit of our gathering may be filled with a truth that will deepen with the passing years. We hope, too, that the meaning of the vows that David and Gwen are about to share with one another will deepen as well as they discover the endless possibilities of this life together. This is the love which need not be tarnished by common events, but which can flower both in deepest adversity and in the greatest joy. As the years go by, you will find more and more in one another a loveliness which neither comes nor goes, which neither flowers nor fades, no longer even taking the form of face or hands, or words or knowing. Everything in your marriage can partake of this mysterious beauty, beyond beauty, until wherever you turn, you see reflections of this loveliness. We ask that the vision you have of one another be always informed by that radiant power which first brought you together. Love is stronger than your conflicts, bigger than life's changes. The miracle always inviting you to learn, to blossom, to expand. It is to love that we must always return. It is my personal prayer and hope that those of you who have already taken the vows of marriage will witness the love of these two people. And as you hear them share their vows, perhaps it will strengthen for you the memory of your happy day and remind you of the meaning of the vows you yourself once took. Perhaps it will even strengthen, just a little bit, the bonds of love that have been growing between you. If any of this should happen, it would certainly be the greatest gift that David and Gwen could offer all of us on their wedding day. David and Gwen, you have given me the greatest honor of joining you in the sanctity of marriage. The ceremony is decreed by the Creator of the universe, also known as God, and is the binding of a couple so in love that they cannot live separated. We'll decree their vows and exchange rings to show all worldly beings this great love that will not be put asunder. Will you, as an expression of your hearts, joined together in love, now please join hands. David, do you take Gwen to be your wedded wife, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful only to her, as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Gwen, you take David to be your wedded husband, to live together in marriage. You promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and health, and forsaking all others. Be faithful only to him as long as you both shall live. We come to the part of the service now where we are going to be lighting the family unity candles. Kason and Nyla are going to light the small candle welcoming Papa Dave to the family. Todd and Brandy will assist them, and then they will light the outside candles. And after a few moments and some words said, I will release Dave and Gwen to light the center candle. From every human being, there arises a light that reaches straight to heaven. And when two souls who are destined to be together find each other, their streams of light flow together, and a single brighter light goes forth from their united being. In this spirit, David and Gwen, take your individual candles and light together a third which signifies your marital bond. May your union be forever blessed. question that I've already answered. Thank you. Traditionally, the marking of the passage to marital status of husband and wife is marked by the exchange of rings. These rings are a symbol of the unbroken circle of love. Love freely given has no beginning. And love freely giving has no beginning and no end. No giver and no receiver. For each is the giver and each is the receiver. May these rings remind you always of the vows that you have taken. David, take Gwen's ring, and as you place it on her finger and bind her to yourself, repeat after me. Gwendolyn, take this ring
as a symbol
of my love for you. I will pledge to you now my love and loyalty forever. Know that I will cherish you always. With this ring, I thee wed. And as you place it on his finger and bind him to yourself, repeat after me. David, take this ring.
David, take this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
For you.
For you.
I pledge to you now. My love and loyalty. Forever.
Forever.
Know that I will cherish you always.
Know that I will cherish you always.
With this ring. I thee wed. David and Gwen, you have consented together to marriage before this company, pledged your faith, and declared your unity by each giving and receiving a ring. And as you are now joined together in mutual esteem and devotion, it is my privilege to offer you this. First one will be a benediction of the First Nations people. Second will be a prayer. Now you will feel no rain, for each of you will bring shelter to the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth to the other. Now there is no more loneliness for you, but there is only one light before you. Go now to your dwelling place to enter into the days of your togetherness. And may your days be good and long on you. Creator God, we approach you asking you to bless this marriage in a very special way. We ask you to take into your hands Gwen and David and guard them against all manner of things that would go against them and keep them at bay. And let their love for you shine on, and may they recognize beyond all doubts your love for them. For we ask it all in Jesus' name. Amen. Signing the ring.
Where?
had asked your photographers to take pictures of this very moment from the scrapbook, remembering, because knowing Gwen as I do through TCF for the last 10 years, this is probably the last time you're ever going to have the upper hand.
So Gwen, does the happy couple have to say something on video? Live video?
Live video.
We did it.
We did it our way. I am so happy to have all our family and friends here, and it's the nicest day of my life, and my daughter's birthday. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Brandy.
Thank you.
This is your birthday present.
Yay!
Thank you. Wish you all to be
here. Yeah. There you go.
Serve it on top, but maybe he meant just for it.
That's okay. Cole did that cake. Isn't it awesome?
You did it?
Cool.
Really?
Yeah. Are we live again?
Why don't you have a toast to each other?
Oh, let's look at this. This is live.
Well, this isn't live. This is just recording.
There you go. No, they were crossing arms.
Okay, everybody, let's just party, okay? This is enough.
So I'm pleased to introduce the head table. So first off, we have bridesmaid Brandy Lee. We have Cindy Brownlee. We have Nyla Greniker. Flower girl. We have the ring bearer, who is Kaysen Greniker. On the guy's side, we have Doug from Victoria. We got John from Victoria. And the bride and groom, Gwen and Dave Delmage. Congratulations. My name is Todd. I'm here to see good evening here. I am the son of Gwen. All right, have a seat.
Let us pray. Thank you, Creator God, supplier of all things that are good. We thank you for this special day to celebrate the wedding. We ask for the opportunity and thank you for the opportunity to break bread together this evening and do more celebrating. We ask it all in your name. Amen.
Keep going.
We went on a couple little trips, and all of a sudden she says, we were hiding her at the house one day, and I said, we were talking about some future planning and some stuff for the future, and I said, you know, what do you think about this? And I said, we're looking at some places for her to move to. And she says, no, she says, let's not talk about that right now. I've got a special someone that I've met, and I'm going to meet him for the first time. I said, okay, well, that sounds great. This one, I think was on a Sunday. Tuesday, she says, I'm going up to Nanaimo on Tuesday. We're going to go up, and I'm going to, meet this guy. We're going to go for dinner. I said, well, that's great. I said, I'm really happy for you. Let me know how you make out. And she says, okay. So off she goes up to Nanaimo, and yeah. That's right, you guys came to Victoria. Dave came down to Victoria, and you guys met each other down at Victoria. And on Wednesday, then you went up to Nanaimo. Great, you went to Nanaimo on Wednesday. Great. So, and there was a wedding that was taking place on the weekend, and it was Jackie and Stan. Was wedding was going to be on the weekend. And Mom asked Dave to go to the wedding. So, and that was on a Wednesday. But also on the Wednesday, you guys ended up buying a fifth wheel and a truck. And we went, well, I haven't met this guy yet, but there's all this stuff that's happening. So on Thursday, they come to my house. And, so I arrive home from work, and there's Dave sitting in the living room. There's Mom sitting at the table, and they've got the box of wine, and everything. We're having a good time. Everybody. So I walk in, and I said, you know, good afternoon. I said, I'm Todd, and I introduce myself to Dave, and we talk for about 10 minutes, and I go into the kitchen where Mom is standing. We're talking for a few minutes, and Dave comes around the corner. He comes up, and he says, he sits down in front of us, and he says, Todd, I have to ask you a question. I said, question? Sure, Dave. What kind of question do you want to ask? You know, do you want directions? Are you hungry? Like, what? You know, anything you want, Dave. I can get you a drink. I can do that too. So he says, Todd, I would like to ask your mom's hand in marriage. I said, what? I says, what? And I said, how long have you guys known each other for? She says, since Tuesday. I says, it's Thursday. You don't ask somebody to get married on a Thursday, like after 2 days of knowing each other. Cole was in the other room, and I went flying into the other room there. I said, Cole, you need to come quick. Like, I need help. Right? So we relay the information again as to what happened to Cole. First thing Cole does, he goes into the other room, grabs a bottle of tequila, pours two shots. Pours a couple shots of tequila type of thing. We do a shot of tequila. I did. Well, he did too. And I welcome Dave to our family. And here we are today. How many months and how many stories have we created? And here we are today, and we're officially part of the family. So, congratulations, Dave. You guys. This is one for the record. Next up, I'd like to welcome my sister, Brandy, to come on up and toast to the bride.
Everyone knows who I am. I'm Brandy, Gwen's daughter, and I'm going to talk to you about being Gwen's daughter, as only I know. I've made a list of things that I learned from my mom. The first one is the idea that I was adopted as a baby, as most of you know. And one thing that I've learned is that biology doesn't really matter. Now I'm going to cry. Which I also learned from my mom. Relationships and love and all that stuff, they are what they are. And it doesn't matter where you came from. It's one thing I've learned. I've also learned how to be a mother. From watching my mother. And I'm a psychologist, and one thing that I ask my clients invariably when I have a session or two with them is, what was your childhood like? You know, what happened when you came home from school and someone was picking on you or stealing your lunch or you got in trouble? What did you do? Who did you talk to? What did they say? And that makes you think about your own childhood. And one thing that I can say for certain is, that I was very loved. And my work has taught me that a lot of people don't have that. And so that's a big deal. And to be able to love and support and encourage children, it does not just come naturally. It needs to be taught and it needs to be learned. And also to be able to set guidelines and standards and expectations, sometimes high expectations, those are all important. And I had all of those things from my mom. She also taught me how to be a wife, how to be a loving, caring, supportive wife most of the time, and that marriage isn't easy. And there's challenges, and the sickness and health thing is pretty major. And Mom and Dave are going to have challenges, as we all do, and they've certainly taught me already, and my mom has taught me about being there for each other, and it's not always fun, and it's not always pretty, but that's marriage, and that's life. I have a Facebook message. My mom also taught me to find a passion in life. For reasons that most of you know about, my mom became very involved with the Compassionate Friends, an organization for people who've lost children. And she didn't get paid, hardly anything, ever. And she worked tirelessly for years and years and years and years. And she did that because she loved it, and she was passionate about it, and it was a calling for her. And that taught me that that was important, and how much money you make at your job isn't as important as whether or not you're finding a purpose in your job and finding meaning. And that was important for me to see. My mom also taught me how to throw a kick-ass party. Woo! Like this one. Every time somebody walked into our house growing up, it was, come on in. It didn't matter if we had makeup on or if the table was set or if the house was clean. It was, come on in, what can I get you? Sit down. Tell me your problems. Tell me what's great. Tell me what's awesome. Let's just have a party. And that's also a skill that I think I have learned from her. I do say so myself. Oh, Todd alluded to this already. We all have instincts and intuition. Mom's is stronger than most. I sometimes ignore mine, but that's me. When Mom met Dave, she followed her instincts. She didn't really listen to logic that said, maybe you might want to date for a while. Maybe you want to get to know each other for a while. Further to Todd's story, I had talked to my mom on that Sunday, and then I talked to her again on Friday. So we all know what happened between Sunday and Friday. I got a message saying, guess what? We've got some news. I think Todd told me, and he said, Mom's getting married. And I'm like, but on Sunday, she didn't even have a boyfriend. So, how is that possible? Well, you know, we met on Tuesday, and then, you know, on Wednesday, we bought an RV, and on Thursday, we, you know, got engaged, and went to Costco, and went to a Jackie and Stan's wedding, so now we've been to a wedding together, and now I'm moving to Nanaimo, and we're getting married. So if I didn't know my mom like I do, I would have gone, oh my God, she's crazy, what's going on, what do we need an intervention? But I went, you know what? She knows what she's doing. She's got intuition and she goes with it, and that's how she lives her life, and that's a good thing. The importance of technology. Technology is important. It's important to know how to use technology. I just found out from Donald that Mom set up a Gmail account for the RSVPs, and apparently she forgot about it, so people are RSVPing via the Gmail account, and she doesn't know what the account is. She's forgotten what the address is or how to access it or what have you, so it's kind of funny. And Mom is on Facebook, just so you know, but if you friend her on Facebook, you will never hear from her. Or she might post something randomly to your wall that has to do with a video that she just saw on someone else's wall. I think she showed me twice now how to choose a mate in life based on mutual trust and respect and support. And that's a big lesson. And I think I've done that as well. We know that Dave is a wonderful, loving man, and we know that he loves her more than anything. And the feeling is mutual, and we love you. You are the papa to our children, and you are officially part of our family. And we're very happy about that. So now I've learned all these lessons from my mom, and now I'm an adult and I can look at her and call her a friend. And I'm very lucky to be able to do that because she's an amazing, gorgeous, stunningly beautiful, caring, inspiring woman. And I love you. So let's have a toast. Let's drink some Prosecco and raise our glasses to the bride, my mom, Gwen Dolmetsch.
And especially when it comes to my friend David. I just can't see. Anyway, good afternoon, good evening, and welcome to David and Gwen's wedding day. They both, I'm sure, would like to thank you for all of you for coming from near and far. I'm blown away by people that came from out of province alone. I mean, you guys know everybody from everywhere.
It's because she told us we had to.
I understand. and sharing in this really a joyous occasion. My name is Doug Campbell, and David and I met around 1999 while he was actually teaching Touch for Health. I met him through a newspaper advertisement, and I was studying another mode of health care. And he was offering this physical end of things. I was into the psychology. I should have used it myself. But anyway, hey, moving on. and as I was saying, he was offering Touch for Health, and that was a very interesting. It's like a hands-on acupressure or acupuncture. So that was easy. No needles, no muscle, no fuss. I don't like needles. Anyway, since that time, we have shared a lot of good times and bad times, a lot of laughter and some sorrows. For a while there, my friend ended up alone, and he talked about selling his home. I'm not sure if you've seen the place, but I'm sure you'll all be invited on Sunday or sooner. It overlooks Departure Bay. The ferries come back and forth. It's just, it's gorgeous. And he's so lonely. He he's going to sell this place and move back to Northern Ontario. Oh! Minus 40 in the winter, plus 40 in the summer, black flies 6 out of 10 months of the year that you can't fight. And well, anyway, we had some serious discussions. And after a couple of Wobble Pops, or, well, more than a few, and some herbal tea, it was good for him, it was healthy. He actually changed his mind and decided to stick around for a while. And through that time, I got him involved in my lodge, fraternal lodge project. And I said, you've got to meet more people, you just can't be lonely all the time. So anyway, he joined our lodge, and that was fine. Then he got onto the Z-Army thing. Lodge went for a shit.
I didn't read this part of it.
Game over for Lodge. Game on for David and Gwen. Game on. I digress.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll just see what I mean. I'll just keep going. Anyway, one trip. So somewhere around that time, I've got to keep on track. He logged onto this dating site, and he told me he met this very interesting lady. And I asked him, does she seem like a nice gal? And he was very emphatic about it, and he assured me that, yes, she was. She seemed like right on. And he was planning a trip to meet her very quickly. Well, one trip to Victoria, and it was all over. And I'm not sure for who. But you know, after two long-term trips in that fifth wheel, I mean, 30 days, 20 days, 30 days, how many?
67.
Holy crap, 67 days in a fifth wheel. Well, you've got to know they had all the bugs worked out. And you know something? I haven't seen you this happy ever. And I've known you since 1999. And I don't think I've ever seen you this happy. And I don't know you that well. You just can't stop grinning. Anyway, it is with much joy for the radiantly beautiful Gwen and her handsome groom, David, that we all wish the both of you much peace and happiness for many, many years to come. Ladies and gentlemen, would you stand with me? I would ask that you toast Mr. and Mrs. David and Gwen Delmarsh. Cheers.
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 Thank you, Chris.
Do I need a microphone?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
We don't really go by, you know, how things are supposed to be done, but as you know. But I do want to say thank you to each and every one of you from the bottom of my heart. I'm really not the perfect angel that I've been portrayed here. My goodness, this is awesome.
You know that, right?
This is awesome. I love this. Yeah, and it's been a lot of work. We've had to plan this for at least 2 months, and 2 months?
Six months.
Dave and I will know one another maybe 2 years in April, I think it is. So we're doing good, you know? But I can't believe everyone really came without knowing or responding to the Gmail. I thank you for doing that. You know, and it just really means a whole lot to see that you've come on a Wednesday on December 12th, 2012. It's been awesome. And I hope everybody tonight has a really good time and a wonderful party, because that's what it is. Let's celebrate life and celebrate Christmas and celebrate one another. And I am the luckiest girl in the world. Thank you.
they gave to me. One black cat, one mortgage house, three tons of junk, and said, Gwenny, will you marry me? And on the next day of April, David gave to me one diesel truck, I was hoping, one URV, one bank loan. Gwenny,